Are we live? We live? Let's transition there. There we go. Hello, ladies and gentlemen. We are here for a, want to say, the third weekly in-house here at Texas A&M.
End of the line.
We did this a little bit last minute, but... Oh my gosh, sorry about that. We did this a little bit last minute, but we got enough people to get a few games going. So I'm your, as always, I'm your caster. Sir, thanks a lot. I was going to be joined by someone else, but he opted out because he has stuff to do. Right now I'm eating, I apologize, but I will do my best to keep track with what's happening around the map. So right now the band's going to Little Debs and Boros, Legion, Yasuo, and Graves. Speaking. Good bands. Lulu definitely a force in the bot lane. Graves probably he is, without a doubt, the best jungler in the game right now. Ooh, the Lee Sin band. Someone must have sniped. I heard someone was going to play Lee Sin on the left team's side.
The joke's on you.
Shaco currently also, of course, has a jungler in the current meta. He sees a lot of play. Definitely very contested pick. Ooh, and the Darius going top lane. We'll see how that one goes. Oh man. Alright, we're back. So we got Braum and Ziggs. I wonder if that's a Zig AD carry. It's going to be really interesting to see, but the bot lane, I think, already got picked right off the bat, unless he's going mid. Mid lane. Hira Senpai opting to go with that Echo. And Hecarim, my god. My buddy Eddie here, a veteran Hecarim player. He used to be a Hecarim top lane before he became such a dominant force in the jungle, so... his Hecarim mechanics are probably still intact. I'm excited to see this. I haven't seen him pull out the Hecarim in a long time. Oh boy. Oh my goodness. It's easy. Don't you try. Goddamn. Right now? Maokai, Malphite, or Poppy. I was gonna say Jax, but Nautilus Rexxum. Oh, never mind, that's a Zix mid. Alright, so I'm gonna wait the 30 seconds because I'm gonna be in a 3-minute delay and I'll give you guys my thoughts on what I think about these two comps. Oh, I'm not against Nautilus. You will get wrecked. Because Wukong relies a lot on his early traits to get away after he does his combo, and all he has to do is auto you, and then he like just autos you ease, and he takes half your health. And if the Nautilus times his W, then you basically did no damage to him. All right, so 2 minutes 30 seconds. We are getting the delay. The teams are probably already loading in. I apologize for the delay. I haven't eaten all day. I'm pretty hungry. College student. Just got his food. So on the left side, we got Darius, Echo, Hecarim, Caitlyn, and Sona. Bot lane is going to be hella oppressive from the blue team. Caitlyn and Sona just poke, like non-stop poke against Vayne and Braum. Yeah, so Vayne and Braum, the tank, and being Vayne, they're going to have to be playing really far back. It's going to be really hard to engage on them unless the jungler helps them. And being a Xin Zhao has his gap closer, but Sona has many, like a lot of ways to like help escape, and Caitlyn with her traps. Caitlyn's not the most mobile carry out there. She's not mobile like at all. She has her little like knockback with the snipe, but what's that ability called? Ferris? Never mind. What's it called? Excuse me. So Hecarim definitely has the edge over Xin Zhao in the early game. Darius versus Camille. That's gonna be interesting. If the Camille plays it right, then she has the potential to be Darius, but if they straight up fight sorry about that. Oh, but if they straight up fight, obviously Darius will win that. Ziggs against Echo. Echo should have the upper hand at all points of the laning phase. That's gonna be a really rough lane for him. That's gonna be a really rough lane for the Ziggs. The early game, I'm gonna give it to the blue team, and then the late game, I mean, Darius is the only one that quote-unquote falls off unless he gets an early lead. So depending on how the Hecarim plays it, the Darius could pop off. Echo's good at all points of the game. Hecarim's good at all points of the game. Caitlyn scales really hard, and she's like Vayne's direct counter. And Sona and Caitlyn just poke the hell out of the bot lane, so that's going to be really rough. The Xin Zhao would probably want to play off this Camille so that they can get some TP plays or roam. Or play off the mid lane, but ganking an Echo is really hard because as soon as he gets his ultimate, he has a lot of ways to escape, and he also has a lot of slows and a lot of different mobility. Sephiroth, show your tits. Someone's messaging me. How's the game going? Not started. Yet. Oh man. I wonder if Scotty's here. No, he's not. Alright, and we are going in, ladies and gentlemen. Let's get to it. Alright guys, we're loading into Summoner's Rift, and from my point of view, let's get this started. We're going to be doing the directed camera just because it's the most efficient way to see what is the most action-packed that is happening inside the game, so let's get right to it. Thank you. That's so strange. Why is it doing that again? Why is it doing that? I apologize for that, guys. Something is up with my league. Why? Something is wrong with my league client. I apologize. What the hell? What the fuck? God, I am so sorry about that. This is the second time OBS does this shit to me. Fucking black screen for no reason. God, I miss so much of the actual game. Okay. I really don't understand why this is happening. Oh, please, come on. There we go, goddamn. Alright, we're finally back live. I apologize for that huge 8-minute delay. Like, this is the second time OBS does this to me. I really don't know why this keeps happening. This is my second time happening, but oh well, let's get back to it. So from the looks of the game, Vayne has 2 kills, the Xinzhao has 0 assists, and the Braum has 2 assists. So I think the bot lane solo killed the red team solo killed their bot lane twice. Jesus. Okay, Weep Senpai Apoc steals the red. Oh no, no, he just lost his red. He died to his red earlier. I thought he was invading. That's strange. For some reason, I thought he was on the red team. Alright, well, let's get back to it. Looks like top lane's winning. Actually, let's fix this shit. There we go. That should do it. Alright, just simple trades. Gluteus looks to put some poke. Kira Senpai, heading in the bush. Is he looking to 1v2? Or is he waiting for his jungler? Now, jungler's bot lane. Looks like he's going to try to do something bot lane. Hecarim has a kill and has died once. I think that was an execute, though, that I managed to catch a glimpse of. Echo died and got an assist, so the mid laner probably got a kill on him, and then the Hecarim killed him. Ooh, they're going hard on this. Ooh, can he 1v2 this? Oh no, and the Ziggs KSing them. Well, not KSing, that's a kill confirmed, but I really don't think the ult was necessary. You know, but better safe than sorry. Ziggs is 2-1 and 0. Echo 0-1-0. 0-1-1. Oh, nice. Really, really good damage there. Oh, he's committing a bit too hard for this. I don't know about this one. Ooh, yeah. That was a wasted flash, but I mean, a good attempt. Got a lot of damage on the Ziggs. Got the ignite off. Yeah, so he got his ignite for a flash. I don't know if that's... I wouldn't call that a really good trade just because the cooldown on ignite is 90 seconds shorter, but a trade nonetheless. Forcing out the ult on Sona. Oh, Weeb Senpai fuck. Looks like he's getting caught out. Oh, will he get away? Oh, a blast clone. He probably will get away. Oh, he doesn't have to use it. Okay, that's good. He gets away. The Sona Sona have to ult bot lane, if not she was a goner. The red team's bot lane is just playing really, really well. Given the fact that the blue team's bot lane counters him pretty hard. Oh, really good damage. Oh, the slow. Are they gonna keep going? Is she gonna have to flash? 1, 2, 3. Ooh, the heal. The ultimate. Sona could be dead here. Ooh, the condemn pushing her away. One more auto. Oh, and Boros Legion gets the kill on. Ooh, this is not good. If Boros Legion connects the auto, I think she dies. Ooh. Good heal. Oh my god, Kira Senpai, is he gonna be the hero that we need? Nope. Maybe the hero that the blue team needs. Top lane's pretty even. But Darius is doing fairly well against the Camille. Oh, and misses the... Oh my god. Just things are not going well for the Darius in that trade. Weeb Senpai Apoc was looking to do something there. But there's a red ward on the try of the red team on the top lane. Oh man, the gold. It's only a 1k advantage for the red team, so the game is still anyone's game. Like I said, the blue team, in my opinion, skills a bit better. I don't want to say harder because Ziggs and Vayne can one-shot people, and the blue team can get very tanky depending on what Echo decides to build. But I know Darius and Hecarim will be very tanky. Ooh, he's going at it again. Oh, did he get her with the fear? Oh, she's dead. 100%. And the dunk from Dunk Master Darius. Really, really good engage there from both the jungler and the top laner. Are they going to try to get this tower? First blood turret hasn't been taken, so they might be looking to put some pressure in the top lane. Are they going to shove? No. Hecarim leaving. Oh, is he going to fight this? This is not a good fight for Weeb Senpai Apoc. And one more auto. Oh, he's dead. Ooh, the Ziggs just getting kills left and right with that really long-range ultimate. Oh, leaving the Caitlyn. 1v2 in the bot lane, that's not good. Big crits, baby, big crits. Camille looking for the roam. Is she's looking for the jungler, or is she just gonna ward? 99 to 99, so the CS is still even in the bot lane for the 80 carries, but the gold deficit is slowly rising. No, actually it's not one, it, well, it's just 100 gold higher. Let's see, let's look at the, oh, not A, is it X? There it is, X. So top lane, the Darius is winning by a marginal amount, almost 800 gold. Hecarim is ahead by 100 gold. Echo is behind by about 800 gold. Caitlyn's behind by about 1,000, no, 900, yeah, it's about 900 to 1,000 gold. And Sona's behind by 200 gold, but the supports aren't really that important in terms of gold income. But yeah, the Vayne is substantially ahead in the bot lane. Ooh, they're going in hard. Not really. Ooh, the ultimate getting canceled with that shield from Braum. Ooh, Senpai wants it. Leave Senpai if I wants it. Oh, will he get it? Ooh, Echo gets the kill on Ziggs. Oh, one more auto. Is he dead? No, he's not. Really, really good fight happening down there. Oh my goodness! Kira Senpai going with the two, with the 1v2, getting the double kill on and stealing the dragon. Man, that was just unfortunate for the Xin Zhao. Probably got caught there at the dragon pit. A lot of stuff, good stuff happening in the bot lane. They're gonna siege this bot tower really hard. Oh, and just like that, the gold deficit now is a gold turnaround for the blue team, with now them with the 1,000 gold lead just off those trades right there. And if they get this tower, will they get this tower? Ooh, they will. Yep, so that's first blood tower for the blue team, and that'll give them 300 global gold and 650 just for Gluteus Maximus. What's the gold lead now? 58-52 to 54-70. So just like that, Caitlyn is now ahead of the Vayne in terms of gold income. She's holding on to 2,200 gold, so right now she's in a bit of a rough spot. Okay, she's backing, so that's good. She's backing, gonna get her items, gonna spend that gold, that cash money. The blue being handed down to Kira Senpai, the mid laner, well deserved after getting those two kills in that roam. We have Senpai Apoc just clearing his jungle, trying to get that gold income, trying to get that Trinity Forest finish so he can start getting tankier and so he can get better engages. Oh man. Ooh, Kira Senpai going really ham on him. Lots and lots of damage, and the passive didn't even proc. My goodness, the damage with just a proto belt, and he has a Negatron cloak, so he's definitely tanky against the Ziggs. Ooh, with Apoc just without any mana. Yeah, this is not a good engagement for them. They should probably back off from this. Ooh, the TP coming in. Is that from Echo? Ooh, cancel the TP. Oh my god, they're committing to this. This is not a good engage. Oh, and he leaves with the ultimate. Oh, wow, she's dead. 100%. Boom. Echo with the kill. Vayne caught a little bit out of position. Did not expect... Well, I mean, again, the Echo had showed in the top lane, so he probably wasn't expecting the Echo to have forded all the way back with his ultimate back to mid lane. So, that's an unfortunate, that's a feels bad, man. Ooh, why is he still fighting this? Oh my goodness, one more auto. And the flash. Unfortunate for the Darius. He already has his Black Cleaver. I'm expecting him to get, like, his tankier items. Camille with the Sheen and the Tiamat, so she wants to be... So she wants to be able to split push early, as it seems. And she's already doing massive amounts of damage just because that Sheen is just, like, super good on her. Super good item on her. Looks like Camille's going to be getting the top lane. Ooh, Weep Senpai Apoc. Trying to do the counter jungling. Can he do this? Oh, and he forces out the flash from Xin Zhao. That's a good trade for the blue team. Now they have the bot and mid turret. Now they're rotating as a team. This is really good rotations. They're shoving mid, making sure that the towers don't get pushed in. Now they're gonna go back to spend some gold. 1,100, 2,000 for Echo. So yeah, they definitely have a lot of income they want to be spending right now. So let's look at the items that these teams are building. Black Cleaver already finished. Trinity Triforce now finished. So now now the Hecarim is going to be able to finish the center hold, get tankier, and then go for maybe definitely a Dead Man's Blade to get that speediness. Or even actually Arando and Zoman, just because they're gonna be, because the Vayne's gonna be hitting really hard with the crit that she's gonna be getting later. Let's see what else. Echo got his two items finished. Did he just buy? Yeah, he just bought the Abyssal Scepter. Ziggs had gotten a lot of kills early, but the roams from Echo and also like the solo trade, the solo fights that he had been like taking on him, have really put him ahead of the Ziggs. Ooh, the poke going in on Flying Wolf. And Flying Wolf opting for the Merc Treads, which is really good because they have the fear, the slow, the fear from Hecarim, the slow from Echo. Ooh, is he gonna do this? Is he gonna get this? Oh, that was so close. That almost connected. Oh, if the shield goes down, that's gonna be devastating. That was so close. That was a really close trade. Oh, a lot of ults going out. The Darius, he's gonna get the dunks reset. The dunk, boom! Boom goes the dynamite. That ult from the Darius. Oh man. I apologize for the quality of the stream. I'm a little frustrated that it did that again. That's the second time that the stream like doesn't show for some reason. OBS screws me, but I mean, what can you do? All right, looks like Ziggs is trying to put some damage here, trying to stop the siege from the blue team on the top lane. Jin Zhao and Vayne are on the way, if you guys are looking at the minimap. Hecarim looks like he's going to go bot, he's going to split push, and Echo's going to be going mid, so they're doing a 3-1-1. Zona's backing, and so is Caitlyn. Let's see what... Oh, she finishes her IE, so now that's the initial power spike that Caitlyn just hit is massive, so she's going to be hitting a lot harder now. Sona got her Sightstone. Yeah, so she's going for the support build. I know that a lot of Sonas have been going for the Lich Bane. What was it? It was Lich Bane with... I can't remember. I know it was Lich Bane and like Frost Queen. Frost Queen's just like right off the bat. Ooh, the damage is coming in. This is not good. Oh, and Apoc getting that kill on Xin Zhao. Ooh, a lot of damage going to Gluteus Maxes. They're probably going to have to back off right here because they're all very low, even though it's a 5v4. Yeah, everyone is nice and healthy from the red team, so they're going to be looking to pressure this dragon. Are they going to try to re-engage? Sona's trying to heal us. Oh my god, Protoss Pianist almost goes down. Little bit ambitious there from Firing Wolf, but nonetheless, the team reacts just in time and he gets picked. Oh, Weep Senpai Apoc is going to go down, and yes, he is. Oh, Echo with the sick plays and the combos. And the ace coming in for the blue team. Now it's a 5k lead. They don't do dragon. They opt to shove mid and see if they can get a tier 2 tower. Yep, that's what they're going to do. Does Darius have TP? Darius does not have TP. I would have liked them to maybe have gone top or bot to shove the wave and get... The top lane turret is very, very low. The Xin Zhao is not even going to try to contest. Will he greed for this, though? I wonder if he'll try to go for the Echo here. Getting that vision and clearing vision, so let's see how it goes. Alright, Darius has his TP back, so he could probably TP back to this dragon if they want to pressure this dragon. It's a really good objective to get, the Water Drake. A little bit underappreciated. That like sustain is very, very good in teams that don't have a lot of like self-sustain themselves. So, and in a comp like the blue teams, who the only people that actually no, they have good amounts of heals. Oh, they burn it. But will that be worth it? Are they gonna go for a second wipe? The Fear Clan connects in two members of the red team. The ult. Oh, Kira Senpai. Kira Senpai times his ultimate just right to dodge the Ziggs ulti and lives. So that's a 3-for-nothing, a 4-for-nothing trade for the blue team. 3-for-nothing. A 3-for-nothing trade for the blue team, but it could be 4 here. Are they going to go for it? I Am Titan is very low, and so is the Camille. They can very easily... right now, the red team should not be greeting for this. They should give up these towers. Oh my goodness. And he gets the Ziggs. He's gonna ult the Echo. Will he go down? Man, he does not go down. Luckily, somebody hits the Camille before the Echo. Very well played, so that they drop turret arrow, and this looks like it's gonna... Yeah, this is definitely an inhibitor right here. Oh, no, and they opt to leave. They can definitely... Oh, the re-engage from the Darius. He's gonna go for it with the Q. Lots of damage going in. Oh, my goodness. They don't have ults. Can they get this? Oh, the heal barely saving Darius, but if that last auto connected... from Vayne, I think that would have been a GG for him. The blue team turning it around. Now almost a 10k gold lead from the blue team. This is brutal. The red team is trying to fight in chokes, and that's just not something you want to do because you have the AoE. You have the AoE fear from the Hecarim with his ultimate. You have an AoE massive burst damage ult with Echo wherever he lands. You have like the AoE from Darius's Q, which heals him right back up, and if he gets any stacks whatsoever from his passive, and he just starts dunking. So you do not want to be fighting in chokes. Yes, it's very good for the Ziggs, but the Ziggs has not been able to finish off kills in the last couple of minutes, so these last couple of fights have to be a little bit smarter from the red team, because the gold lead is getting exponential on the blue team, and that is just not good for them. That's not good for the red team. Alright, they didn't greed, but at least they have bot exposed, so at least they have a win condition. Even though they're dominating this game, you always want to be looking at where your win conditions are, so you can possibly end the game at some point if you get a good lead, or maybe pressure with one character and get Baron. Ooh. Are they gonna go for this? That's a lot of damage coming in from the Sona. My goodness, half of the Xin Zhao's health just dropping. Sieging the mid lane. Yeah, mid lane and top lane have both really low on their turrets, so they just have to keep pressuring here. The red team's gonna have to look for a good pick or just a good engage on the team fight, because it's just really hard for them to win team fights with, oh my goodness, the 1v1, I believe, in Darius. Yeah, Darius getting those massive amounts of armor, although he should be getting a spirit visit just so he can get that extra sustain from the passive. Hecarim getting the chilling smite. I see a lot of Hecarims take the red smite, but the chilling smite's definitely good to finish off targets, especially with how immobile the Caitlyn and Darius are, so that will help them catch up to a target if they're going for a pick. Zhonya is definitely a very good choice on the Echo, not wanting to go too ham too early. Always defensive is always good. Echo's still going to do lots of damage, especially against their team, who the only like dedicated tank that they have is Brahma, but he's going for the support items right now, so he's not that tanky. He just has a good amount of health. He's just really healthy. So going defensive early, at least for me, is an okay. Oh, they're going hard on this. The Xin Zhao has no tank item. He's so squishy. Oh, the Hecarim engages. The Fear lands on the Brahmin. He's going to go down. The I Am Titan is trying to put as much damage as he can, but not a lot of damage is going on them. Kira Senpai is trying to get this. Kira-senpai trying to get this inhibitor. Will he get it? Yeah, he probably will. He's zoning out the Caitlyn, the Camille really well. And that is inhibitor for the blue team. Ooh, they're going for it. Can they get it? No, they aren't. And while three people are dealing with Echo, that's a free mid turret for the blue team there. The TP going in the bot lane, they're gonna go hard bot. Oh, Dunkmaster here just wanted to make sure that he was alive, so now they're rotating into the top lane, trying to get more towers, trying to get more objectives, trying to push their lead as best as they can, because they are immensely far ahead. 11,000, almost 12,000 now here, gold lead for the blue team. The amount of snowball that the blue team has with their team is just insane. It's just unbelievable. So we need to see what the red team will opt to do in order to get back into this game. Ooh, and the Baron play from the blue team. Camille tries to do something there, but she can't really do much because there's super minions at the base and Vayne is trying to clear them. Oh, the Darius not given a, not given an if, dies, but the Camille is extremely low. I still think the blue team can still fight this. Look at that damage going in. One more auto. My goodness, that almost kills the Xin Zhao. That red buff is just brutal with that true damage. Luckily, the Braum was there to shield him. And the red Drake is definitely going to be going to the blue team. Man, the snowball keeps getting even more snowball-y-er, if that's even a term. 8% more AD and AP for the blue team. And they back. The red team just scrambling here around the lanes, trying to clear their way, trying to clear the waves, trying to get back into this game. Just farm, get those late game items, because the red team does spike really good later. But the Xin Zhao right now should be opting for defensive items, because he is just not getting much done in the team fights as it is. He just gets three autos from the Caitlyn. That's almost dead for him. An auto or an ability from anyone else on their team, and that's GG for him. So I really hope that he picks up some defensive items soon. My goodness, the Caitlyn with the last whisper. So now it doesn't even matter if you have armor. She's going to be shredding right through it. Yeah, these guys really want that top lane really, really hard. Oh my god, one auto and that's three quarters of his health. Apoc with the BM. Oh, they're trying to hard engage. Kira Senpai with a really good... Is he going to ult? Yeah, he ults and he gets his health back and the massive amount of damage going on everyone. Kira Senpai going to town. The zoning from the Hecarim. Now that it's a late game, he has all his tank items. They're having a hard time bringing him down. And he's putting some good damage in. Three people fall. Two of them are almost dead. Camille trying to make a play here. Oh, is he going to get it? Yeah, he gets the AD carry, but it doesn't matter. Echo gets it. And is this game... I don't think Fatty Fool here can defend against all this. Yep, this looks like it's a GG, well played. Yep, and that's a GG, well played for the blue team. Alright. Alright, so let's go back to the Discord and see what the teams are saying. Let's see if they have any shit talking they might want to do. Damn, that was brutal.
Yeah, dude, we gave him the dick.
Did you see my amazing death to red?
Yeah, I did. But lucky for you, earlier on the stream, like when I got it started, like it glitched on me. So for 8 minutes.
Hello.
What was?
Someone was playing my thing, so I stopped talking.
Holy shit, wait, we 4v5'd them, I just realized.
Yep. You guys could have won like a bunch of 4v5s.
There we go, Ham.
Oh,
what is that?
Here for a, wanna say the third weekly in-house here at Texas A&M.
Oh, that's the beginning. You're not gonna see your int.
Oh my gosh, we did this a little bit last minute.
I saw my
int. We got enough people to get a few games going, so I'm your, as always, I'm your caster. Sure, thanks a lot.
Could you like?
I'm not George later.
Else, but, you have to leave.
Huh?
You have to leave or what?
No, I was gonna say yeah. I'm gonna get food.
Right, no, I'm eating. Right, gotcha. Apologize, but
yeah, we're gonna get food
to keep track yeah. with right. what's happening on well, the map.
I guess I'm gonna.
Yeah.
Going to okay. Little Devs and Boros.
I guess I'm gonna end the stream there.
I am.
Well, guys, I'm gonna end the stream there. I'm sorry for the technical difficulties early. I hope you guys enjoyed it. I was a little salty and it showed, and I apologize. I will make sure next time that it doesn't do that, or as soon as I catch it, I'm just gonna stop OBS and restart it. So this is your Thanks a Lot, and I'll catch you in the next one. Peace.